Hey, to you. That's right, you that's watching my vlog right now. This is another cat show vlog by The Fancy Cats World. I just wanted to say a huge thank you to everybody that watched our last cat show vlog. We had some really positive feedback in the comments, as well as from friends, so we really appreciate all of the interaction and love. We are back today with our final cat show before Christmas. I got them all vetted in and settled into their pens before heading out to check out all of the stalls, of course. I had this amazing rosette frame to collect from certificates. I actually ended up having Muffin's premier certificates as well as the rosette that came with her final one. I think it's really special to get it framed since it all went to her first title. So yeah, it's hanging on the wall at home now. So by the end of the vlog, you will have seen it. By the time I finished looking at all the stalls and spending way too much money, I headed over to the results board, and this is where I checked all of my girls' results. How to check results is you find out what class your cat was being shown in, and then you'll find the little ticket with the number on it. So for example, the class was C140, you'll go over to that ticket, and then if your cat's got something, it will be written down on the little ticket. Talk some more about my girls' results in a bit, but this is something that I really need to show everyone. The cutest reunion ever. Twinkie had a little reunion with her breeder, aka Nanny, and it was really cute to see her reaction. I swear she recognised her well. She's definitely enjoying all the love and attention. Results time. So as you see here, Twinkie's got three rosettes. First place for Cumberland Cat Club, first for Yorkshire County Cat Club, and a best of breed for the Cumberland Cat Club. Muffin got a first in the Cumberland Cat Club and a reserve grand premier for the Yorkshire. Tony got a first place in the Yorkshire County Cat Club, as well as her very first Master Cat certificate. I'm so pleased for her. Here's some of the cats that Twinkie's breeder brought along with her. Some of these are actually related to Twinkie, which is really cute. Again, it's part of the whole family reunion. Having a little whoopsie with the blanket in the pen there. Here's some slow-mo judging action. A huge part of the shows is staying safe. And as you can see here, they're disinfecting their hands and the table in between each cat. I've tried to keep all of the breeds together in the video, so here's some beautiful Siberians. These little kittens were so playful and literally were like stealing my heart the whole entire day. I mean, just look at them. They're so adorable. After watching our cat show vlogs, what do you think your favourite breed of cat is? Tell us in the comments. One of my new favourites is the Selkirk Rex. You'll see some of those coming up very shortly. Some more beautiful Siberians. Moving on to one of my fun favourites, the Ragdoll, of course. This is a gorgeous seal tabby point and white bicolour. Another sweetheart of the day that I found. Her name was Chocolate. Just look at her rolling around the pen for me. This is one of the reasons that I love Ragdolls so much. Their temperament is just, oh my gosh, they're just amazing cats. Beautiful cream ragdoll. This seal point and white bicolour ragdoll was actually in the pedigree pet section. If you take a closer look, I think the reason that he's in the pedigree pet section is because he's actually got a full white arm on the one side. I think it's really cute and so unique. The pedigree pet section is for those pedigree pets who don't fit the standard of point for their breed, but are still as equally beautiful and definitely deserve their chance to win many rosettes, many prizes, and show off their amazing good looks. I'm not sure since when they allowed panthers at cat shows, but apparently they are now allowed to be shown. You could almost compare this Maine Coon to a lion. It's like really primal looking, so majestic, and yeah, just like a raw cat energy. You could really see and imagine this cat like striking after an antelope in the desert. I don't know if that's just me. Thank you. Today's show was actually a super special one. It was a triple show. So we had the British Short Hair, the Yorkshire Cat Club, as well as the Cumberland Cat Club as well. And I've never seen so many British Short Hairs in my life. So we've got pen after pen. I think this is Silver Spotted. It might be Silver Tabby. I'm not 100% well versed in the colours of the British short hairs. Another really popular colour was the blue grey points of British short hairs. Again, just pen after pen. And they're all so cute, just like miniature teddy bears. By this time in the day, all of the main classes had been judged and the side classes were just left. So at this point, it's normally okay to pop a little treat or some food into the pen for your cat, as they're probably hungry since I've been out all day. Going around the show hall now, you'll see lots of heavily decorated pens with lots of fancy rosettes. Here are some of Tony's neighbours in the pedigree pet section. Tony's next door neighbour, Antony. We have another miniature panther in the household section. Oh, there's two miniature panthers. They're multiplying. Get ready to see Tony's twin in 3, 2, 1. Ah! At this show, there was genuinely a fan club for Jeremy. There were like people literally gathering around like, is this Jeremy? Is this Jeremy the cat? So many people came to see him today, which is really amazing because I love the Selkirks. And again, we've got some more really cute Selkirks here. Walking around the show, you'll see lots of busy judges with lots of busy stewards doing all sorts, including judging cats, going around taking the cats out of their pens for judging as well, as you can see here. It's always fun to watch the judging, but if this is taking place, make sure you're stood well away from the judging taking place. Number one rule is don't talk to the judges whilst they're judging. So if you've got any questions for any of the judges, maybe about why your cat didn't or why your cat did make a place, you can always ask them at the end of the show day. This is what I was talking about earlier, pen to pen with blue British short hairs. They're all so adorable, but it felt like I was seeing multiple. I've never seen so many in one place under one roof at the same time. It was so cool. As always, to finish off any show, we have the best of the best being judged at the very end. This cat being judged right now has got an amazing temper, I've got to say. Just look how chilled out they are. Can't wait to see the day that one of my cats is in one of these top pens, hopefully. Here's one of Cumberland Cat Club's top winners of the day, this gorgeous curly cutie. Selkirk Rexes have a really laid-back personality, quite similar to the Ragdoll's temperament. I think it's only fair that we all get to have a cuddle, right? Another fabulous show and a lovely day out. Can't believe that we've had a whole year at showing now, and there's not going to be one for us until next year because we're too tired. We want Christmas off showing. Here we are, all packed up and heading back to the car to get home. It's literally pitch black outside. Me and Tony in the car. The big certificates frame reveal. Dun, dun, dun. Isn't it stunning? Guys, I was like trying to get it up straight for so long and I finally did it. So here you are, you can all see it in its glory. It's up next to their Poke Pet canvas. Cat parents can relate. I cried real tears when I saw this on my wall. Real tears! And of course I've got to show YouTube the obligatory Instagram pictures as well. I hope you all enjoyed our cat show vlog. And we will be back with the cat show content in 2023. Here's all of our rosettes just in 1 year of cat showing. So if you're interested in cat showing, don't hesitate, just go for it. If you're in the UK and you're interested in starting cat showing and you don't know where to start, pop us a DM over on Instagram. It's at TheFancyCatsWorld. Our DMs are open to all and everyone looking for some tips, advice on how to get started. Maybe you want some grooming advice, some temperament advice, just anything really. We're happy to help and we want to expand the community. So make sure you like, follow, share and subscribe to our channel for more. And peace and love.